Bakker, the naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming and checking out the channel. We're back on the topic of fatty acids. We're talking now about the differences between omega-3 versus omega-9. So let's talk about those. So 9, when we look at omega-9, we've not really got an essential fatty acid in the diet. But what we have got are quite interesting different fatty acids indeed. Oleic acid, for example, in olive oil is considered an omega-9. So it's monounsaturated, basically. So we've got about four main types of different acids, or we could call them, or components that make up omega-9. Oleic acid, we've got meat acid, we've got erucic acid and nervonic acid, but the one I've heard a lot about is the oleic acid. This has been linked in several studies with low inflammation. So people who tend to have a lot of olive oil in their diet tend to have a lot less problems with their heart, with diabetes, with arthritis, with pain. So the difference is omega-9 is non-essential, omega-3 is essential. We need to get omega-3 in our diet all the time. Omega-9 we don't, because it's not an essential thing. But the benefits conferred by omega-9 are pretty good. They're probably better in some sense than omega-6. But remember, 3, 6, and 9, you want to get a nice even balance of these fatty acids. So omega-3 is essential. All right, and we just spoke about omega-3 before, about the three fatty acid fractions that make it up. Alpha-linolenic acid, DHA, and EPA. So you can get those from plant sources. But primarily you're going to get them from fish and animal sources, the EPA and DHA. But EPA and DHA basically come from animals that live or feed on algae, right? And fish eat fish, eat fish, so you've got a food chain going up. So the bigger the fish, often the richer and the more of these fatty acids in the body from consuming that chain going all the way up. Whereas if we look at olive oil, large amounts of oleic acid and omega-9, monounsaturated, actually showing anti-inflammatory properties, a bit like omega-3, and it's a big part of the Mediterranean diet. So research isn't that 100% conclusive on oleic acid, but what I can say is the people I know that live on olive oil, they're part of their diet, don't tend to have many problems with their heart. Thanks for tuning in.